About 10 years ago, two engineers studying fluid behavior on board NASA's low-gravity aircraft had some time to kill. And they got to thinking, what would happen if you pop a water balloon in space? This. That's Seth Lichter, now a mechanical engineer at Northwestern University. He thought the balloons might demonstrate some basic physics of how water behaves.
And I started thinking about, well, what would Galileo do to try to illustrate the fundamental physics?
And then it was just the fun factor.
And that's Mark Weislogel, now a mechanical engineer at Portland State University. NASA's low-gravity aircraft simulates weightlessness by flying in a special parabola.
Basically trying to fly the path that a rock would fly if you just let it go. And the plane did something like 60 of these parabolas, just one low-gravity thing after another.
And that's a lot of stomach drops, Lichter says.
We go up, the second cycle, I am sick as a dog.
It's a 12,000-foot high roller coaster.
Every cycle, I'm throwing up.
At the beginning, it's gut-wrenching.
Please stop me at any time if this is too much. My breakfast came up.
Yeah, that's too much.
But once you acclimate, then it's euphoric.
And for you, Dr. Lichter?
Slightly better.
Part of the appeal of the water balloons is that they give you an easy way to make big water blobs on the spot with no fancy equipment. And that's because of the way that the balloon pops. You can see it here in these high-speed videos. When you pop a water balloon, even here on the ground, the first thing that happens is that the latex unwraps, leaving behind a big ball of water. On the ground, of course, that doesn't last long.
Only for a split second. Then gravity starts working on it, and the water blob starts to fall.
And it takes that nice spherical shape and flattens it out.
And it doesn't take hardly anything before friction with the air rips it apart into drops. And so that's why raindrops are a certain size and no bigger. Any bigger, and air drag
caused by gravity
rips them to pieces and they get smaller.
Now imagine a raindrop in zero gravity. It's not just that it doesn't fall down.
In zero G, surface tension can act to hold together any size droplet because it's the only force acting on the droplet.
So the size of a raindrop in space? Unlimited. For Science Friday, I'm Flora Lichtman. We'll be right back.